and welcome. I'm Aaron, and I'm a product manager for IntelliCode suite of features in Visual Studio. Today, we're going to look at our suggestions feature set, specifically suggestions for repeated edits to help you do your refactorings, and suggestions for quick actions, which will help you do your Roslyn quick actions in your code. Let's start with repeated edits. So here we are in a solar system code base, and we've got a program that helps calculate distances within the solar system. And so we're given our base system, base units in kilometers, and we're going to return some distances in astronomical units and in light years. So we can see here in the base code, the calculations are in the return statement, and it looks quite messy. So what I've gone ahead and done is write some functions to do the conversion for me. And so we're going to go ahead and start doing our refactorings for our conversions into light years. So I'm going to start here by making my first edit. Kilometers to light years. That's the first repeated edit. I'm going to do my second repeated edit here. That's my second repeated edit. And we can see here that IntelliCode has detected the repeated edit in the other locations where I might want to do this. So there's two ways to use this feature. You can either use the screwdriver here with your cursor or by hitting Control Period. And here we see that we can apply the repeated edit suggestion to just this example or the remaining examples inside this file. There's another way that we can use this feature, and this method is entirely in your flow. And so if I just type in kilometers to light years, we see that the suggestion actually appears in my completions list. So you don't have to go looking. If IntelliCode suggestions has detected this repeated edit, we will actually put it in your flow in your completions list, and you can do this all by typing. So I want you to notice here that there's actually a key binding to go to the next instance of the suggestion as well. So I'm going to hit enter here, and that's applied it. We've got one example left, and we can do this either using the key binding or in the tool window below. So I'm going to use the key binding, Control Alt comma, and you can see here that we've actually suggested this repeated edit in your code. And so I'm going to hit Control Alt period. Cool. So this is repeated edit suggestions after two examples. But in some cases, we can actually do this after one example. So I'm going to go into the refactorings for kilometers to astronomical units. So here, again, kilometers to astronomical units. This is my first one. I'm going to control hit comma. I'm going to go to my next example here, and I'm going to hit control alt period. So you can see here, because I am specifically asking for the change to be made with control alt period, it has gone ahead and applied this for me. And again, we've got two instances left. And we can again use similar method to apply this. So I'm going to use the light bulb this time to apply all the other suggestions. So as you can imagine, if you've got many similar edits to do in a given file, IntelliCode suggestions can really help you save some time by finding the remaining locations and doing the edits for you. no matter how complex they can be. In some instances, we can save minutes, tens of minutes, or even hours, depending on the complexity and the frequency of the edit. So switching gears a bit, we're going to look at IntelliCode suggestions for quick actions. I've got a class here of planets that I'm going to start authoring. So let's begin. We'll want to keep track of some properties like the diameter of a planet and the composition of a planet. And I'm going to begin writing my constructor. So because I've just written some properties, and now I'm going to write a constructor with the properties, IntelliCode has detected that I'm intending to do this. And based on the detected intent, it's going to suggest that I generate the constructor. So look at this. By writing the properties and starting my writing my constructor, IntelliCode can now suggest, oh, I can complete this constructor for you. So this is the first of two quick actions that we support, generating a constructor. And this is another example of IntelliCode writing the routine code edits for you so you can stay focused on the code that matters. I'm going to hit enter. And look at that, it's generated the constructor for me. Now, what if I've forgotten a property and I want to add a property to this constructor now? So I'm going to start writing a property to keep track of the distance from the sun. I'm going to cursor into the constructor that we've just generated, and I'm going to begin double distance from sun. And look at this again, in your flow, in your completions list, we can help you complete this code edit. I'm going to hit enter to accept, and I'm going to show you one more example. Now, what if we have a planet that doesn't have moons? Not every planet has moons, and that's okay. We love those planets too. So I'm going to start typing int, and we can see again, the suggestion shows up, but wait, we can add the optional parameter into your constructor for you. So I'm going to hit enter here to accept. So what have we just seen? We've seen IntelliCode detect that by adding properties and starting to write my constructor. In my completions list, I have the option to let IntelliCode suggest a quick action and complete the code change for me by generating my constructor. We've also seen the second quick action that we can suggest, which is by adding the property to the class and then cursoring into my constructor, IntelliCode can suggest adding that parameter to the constructor for me, whether it's mandatory or optional. So, in short, between suggestions for repeated edits and suggestions for quick actions, IntelliCode can help you make the changes that you're intending to make and help you stay focused on the work that matters. So thank you for joining me today.